Good morning students, let's learn today ratios to percents. Ratios to percents. Sometimes facts are given us in the form of ratio and we need to convert to percents. Means sometimes facts are given in the form of ratio and we need to convert those facts in the percents. Now see here one example is given. Reena's mother said to make idlis. Okay, to make idlis. You must take 2 parts rice. How many parts rice? 2 parts rice. See here given, I will write 2 parts rice. Okay, 2 parts rice and 1 part ulad dal. Okay, and 1 part and 1 part urad dal. Okay, so what it is asked? What percentage of such mixture would be rice and what percentage would be urad dal? Means we have to find the percentage. Now what it is given? These parts are given in the form of ratio. What is the ratio? Rice is to urad dal. It is given or not? Rice is to urad dal. See how much rice it is given? 2. 2 parts rice and 1 part urad dal. So what is the ratio? 2:1. So what is the ratio given? Ratio is given 2:1. Okay. So see here, ratio is given 2:1. Rice is to urad dal. Okay. Ratio is given. Rice is to urad dal. So what is the ratio? 2:1. So what is the ratio is given? 2:1. 2 parts rice and 1 part urad dal. So ratio is 2:1. What is the ratio? 2:1. 2:1. Ratio is given 2 parts rice and 1 part urad dal. So how much total? 2 plus 1. So 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. 2 plus 1. So total parts 3. So 3 is the total of all parts. Okay, total of all parts. So what is the total of all parts? 3. See, 2:1. What is the ratio? 2:1. 2 parts rice and 1 part urad dal. It is given. So 2 plus 1. So how much total? 3 is the total of all parts. 3 is the total of all parts. Okay, so let's find now percentage. The percentage of rice would be, what will be the percentage of rice? Percentage of rice would be, now how much percentage of rice it will come? How much parts of rice? 2 parts rice. So 2. From how many parts? 2 parts rice. From 3 parts. Total parts are 3. Total parts are 3 and from that 2 parts are rice. So we have to find the percentage of rice would be. Multiplied by what will come? Multiplied by 100%. We have to find the percentage of rice now. So percentage of rice will be 2 parts. Why I took rice? It is given 2 parts rice. From total parts are 3. From 3 parts, 2 parts rice. So we have to find the percentage. How much percent? 2 parts rice from total 3 parts. Okay, from total 3 parts, 2 parts rice. So how much percent it is that we have to find? So we need to multiply by 100%. Means we have to find the 100% na. So multiply by 100. Okay, so let's find the answer for these. So 2 multiplied by 100, 200. Okay, 200 upon 3. Okay, so now divide for 200 by 3. Divide for 200 by 3. For 200, if I will divide by 3. 3 6 are 18. Okay, 20 minus 18. place. Okay. So now what we got as a 66 integer 2/3%. What we got? 66 integer 2/3%. So percentage of rice would be 66 integer 2/3%. See, this is given in ratio. Ratio is given and we are going to convert into percent. So each part will convert. Now see, rice, how much it is given? Two parts. So two parts we need to convert into percent. So total parts how much? Three parts are total parts. See, 2 + 1. Two parts rice and one part urad dal. So total parts 3. So 3 is the total of all parts. Okay. So percentage of rice would be 2/3 × 100. Okay. And we are finding the percentage. So give here percent sign. Okay. So now 2 × 100, 200. 200 divided by 3. So divide for 200 by 3, you will get 66 integer 2/3%. Okay. Now we found for which percentage of rice. Now let's find for percentage of urad dal. Okay. Percentage of urad dal would be. See here I will draw this. Write it down. I don't have place on the board to write. Percentage of urad dal would be. Percentage of urad dal would be, how much it is? Percentage of urad dal would be, how much it is? Now see, how much it is? How much urad dal it is? One part is urad dal. See, one part is urad dal. What it is given? Two parts rice and one part urad dal. So one part is urad dal. So what it will come? Urad dal is one part. From out of how many part? One part is urad dal out of three parts. Total parts are 3. So write it down here, 3. At denominator space. Total parts are 3. And one part is urad dal. Okay. So find the percentage. Multiply by 100%. How much percent urad dal? That we have to find. So how much part urad dal? One part. Out of three part, one part is urad dal, so multiplied by 100. We are going to convert this into percentage. So multiplied by 100. Okay. So is equal to, now convert this. Now 1 multiplied by 100. 100 upon 3. Now let's divide this. What we get? See, 100 divided by 3. 100 divided by 3. So 100 divided by 3. 3 threes are 9. 10 minus 9, 1. Okay. Now 0 will come down. 3 threes are 9. Okay. Again, remainder is 1. Okay. So now see, denominator 3. You know now to convert this fraction into mixed fraction. See, this is improper fraction. And we are going to convert into mixed fraction. This is improper fraction. For this fraction, we have to say the improper fraction. Everyone knows this because its numerator is greater than its denominator. So this is improper fraction. So we need to convert into mixed fraction. So how to convert? Divide for 100 by 3. So what is denominator? 3 is denominator. What is whole number part? 33 we got. And what is remainder? We got 1. That we have to write at numerator space. So what we got? 33 integer 1/3%. So what we got answer? 33 integer 1/3%. Okay, so what we got answer? 33 integer 1/3%. So we got percentage of urad dal would be 33 integer 1/3%. So we got both the percentage. Rice also we got in the percentage and urad dal also we got in the percentage. So how to convert, understood? So exercise 8.3, question number 1. Tell what is the profit or loss in the following transactions. Also find profit percent or loss percent in each case. Okay, means we have to find whether it is profit or loss in given transaction. And we have to find the profit percent or loss percent. Means if it is profit in the transaction, we have to find profit percent. And if it is loss in the transaction, we have to find the loss percent. Okay. Now see, first one example. Garden shares bought for rupees fraction, do in rough. See, 325 minus 250. 5 minus 0, 5. Okay, 2 minus 5 is not possible. So, take borrow. So, what will come here? 12. Okay, here will remain 2. So, 12 minus 5, 7. And 2 minus 2, 0. So, what we got? Rupees 75. So, rupees 75, what we got? This is profit. So, profit how much it is? Profit is equal to rupees 75. Now, what it is asked in the question? Also, find profit percent or loss percent. Now, here we got profit. So, we'll find the profit percent. So, here I will write the formula for profit percent. Already I have explained you this profit percent. What is the formula for profit percent? Profit upon CP. Profit upon CP multiplied by 100. Profit upon CP multiplied by 100. Okay. So, what is the profit in this transaction? 75 rupees profit. Okay. So, write in the place of profit 75. Then, cost price how much it is? Cost price 250. Cost price is 250. So, write here 250 multiplied by 100. Now see what we can do is upper 0, downside 0 get cancel. Okay, so what will remain here? 75 upon 25 multiplied by 10. Now 25 ones are 25, 25 threes are 75. Okay, 25 ones are 25, 25 threes are 75. So what remain here now? 3 multiplied by 10. 3 multiplied by 10, 30. Okay, so profit percent 30. Okay, so profit percent 30. Okay, see now the question. A skirt bought for rupees 250. Skirt bought for rupees 250 means what is the cost price? 250. So cost price CP is rupees 250. Okay, and sold at rupees 150, and for how much rupees it is sold for? 150. So selling price is equal to rupees 150. Okay, so now see here, skirt bought for rupees 250 and it is sold at 150 rupees. Okay, so now in this transaction we got profit or loss. See, cost price is more than selling price. Cost price is more than selling price. Then obviously it is loss. See, selling price is less than cost price. Selling price is less than cost price. So obviously loss. See, I bought it for 250 and I sold it for 150. Obviously, I will get loss in this transaction. So, what we have to find here? Loss. Okay, so what it will come? Loss. How much loss it is? So, loss is equal to. Now, what is the formula for loss? Cost price minus selling price. Okay, cost price CP minus SP. Okay, what is the formula for loss? CP minus SP. Now CP means cost price. How much cost price? Rupees 250. So 250 minus selling price. How much it is? 150 rupees. Okay, so now subtract is 0 minus 0, 0. 5 minus 5, 0. 2 minus 1, 1. Okay, so rupees 100. So how much rupees loss it is? 100 rupees loss it is. It is 100 rupees loss. Okay, so now we got loss. Now what it is asked in the question? Also find profit percent or loss percent. Now see, we got here loss, so we'll find the loss percent. Okay, So loss percent is equal to, what is the formula for loss percent? Loss upon CP multiplied by 100. Okay, loss upon CP means cost price multiplied by 100. So loss, how much we got here? 100 rupees, 100 loss. What is the CP? Cost price is 250 multiplied by 100. Okay. So now see here, upper 0, downside 0 get cancelled. How much will remain here? 10 multiplied by 100 upon 25. Okay. Now 25 ones are 25. 25 fours are 100. Okay. So what remain here? 10 multiplied by 4. So 10 multiplied by 4, 40. Okay. So loss percent. How much loss percent it is? Loss percent is 40. Loss percent. It asks to find the loss percent. So how much it is? 40. Okay. So question number 2. Convert each part of the ratio to percentage. Convert each part of ratio to percentage. Now these are the given ratios and we need to convert this into percent. Now first we will find the how many total number of parts. See, this is given ratio. So first we will convert the ratio into fraction. Okay, first we will convert the ratio into fraction and then we will convert into percentage. See now, 3 is to 1. 3 is to 1 means first we will see the total parts. Total parts. Now 3 is to 1. What is the ratio? 3 is to 1. So total parts. The first part is 3. Second part is 1. So 3 plus 1 is equal to 4. So total number of parts are 4. Okay. So first part will come 3 upon 4. And the second part will come 1 upon 4. Total parts are 4. Okay. So first part, what it will come? 3 upon 4. And second part will come 1 upon 4. So let's convert this into percentage. Okay. So 3 is to 1. This ratio we have to convert into percentage. So first what we did, we find the total parts. Total parts means 3 plus 1. What is the ratio? 3 is to 1. So 3 plus 1. So total parts we got 4. Okay. Total parts are 4. So 3 upon first part is 3 upon 4 and second part is 1 upon 4. Let's convert this fraction into percentage. Okay. So 3 upon 4. Let's convert this into percent. So fraction convert into percent. What we are going to do? We are going to multiply by 100. So multiply by 100. Okay. Percent will come here. Now see here, 3 upon 4. See here, I will write again 3 upon 4 multiplied by 100. Okay. Percent. So 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8, 4 fives are 20. Okay, if you will divide by 4 for 100, what you will get here? 25. Okay, so 3 into 25, 75. See, 25 threes are 75. So 75%. So what we got first part? We got 75%. Now let's find the another part. Okay. See here, I will draw this. Now I have the place here. So what is the another part? See here. 3 upon 4. This is first part. Now second part is 1 upon 4. See, second, what it is? See, 3 is to 1 ratio. Second part is 1 upon 4. Okay, so 1 upon 4 we need to convert into percentage. So 1 upon 4 multiplied by 100%. Okay, so now write here 1 upon 4 multiplied by 100. Okay, percent will write here. So do the lowest term here. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8, 4 fives are 20. So 1 multiplied by 25. So how much we got? 25 ones are 25. So 25%. So first part is 75% and second part is 25%. Understood this? So first part is 75%, and second part is 25%. Okay, so now B question. Okay, 2 is to 3 is to 5. So let's find first total parts. Okay, total parts. Total parts. How many total parts are there here? 2 plus 3 plus 5. Okay, total parts are ours here. First part is 2, second part is 3, and third part is 5. So total parts is 5 plus 3, 8, 8 plus 2, 10. So total parts are 10. 10 parts we got. Now we have to convert this ratio into percent. So let's first convert this ratio into fraction. Total parts are 10. So first part is 2 upon 10. Second part is 3 upon 10. Why 10 underscore? Because total parts are 10. So first part is 2 upon 10. Second part is 3 upon 10. And third part is 5 upon 10. This is not my own 10 I have written. Total parts we got 10. So take 10 as a denominator. Means total parts. Okay. So now let's convert this fraction into percent. Okay, let's convert this fraction into percent. So let's convert this first part into percentage. Okay, so 2 upon 10. Now we are going to convert the fraction into percent. So what we are going to do? Multiply by 100. Okay, multiply by 100. Right here, percent sign. We are going to convert into percent. So we have percent sign. Okay, so now 2 upon 10. See here, I am again writing this. Now what we can do? This 0, upper 0, downside 0 get cancelled. This is upper 0, you know, number 100. It is at numerator place. So these and this 0 can get cancelled because this 10 is at denominator place. So this 0 get cancelled. So how much remain at numerator place? 2 multiplied by 10. So 2 multiplied by 10. 20. So what we got? 20%. So first part is 20%. Now let's find the second part. Okay. Now second part is 3 upon 10. Okay. This fraction is 3 upon 10. Now let's convert this fraction into percent. So what we are doing? Multiply by 100. Okay. So now do the calculation here. 3 upon 10 multiplied by 100. Okay, now this 0 and this 0 get cancelled. Upper 0, downside 0 get cancelled. Okay, so now what will remain here? See, 3 multiplied by 10. 3 multiplied by 10. See, numerator, denominator place it is 1. How, what it is remain 1? So you will not write even though. Okay, so 3 tens are 30. So what we got? 30%. So what we got? Second part we got 30%. Now let's find for third part. Okay. So third part is 5 upon 10. So 5 upon 10. This we are going to convert into percentage. So multiply by 100. Okay. So 5 upon 10 multiplied by 100. So now see this 0 or 0 downside 0 get cancelled. Okay, so what will remain here? 5 into 10. 5 into 10. So 5 into 10, 50. So 50%. So now see here we got first part is 20%, second part is 30%, and third part is 50%. Okay, so what is this question? Convert each part of the ratio to percentage. So each part of ratio we convert into percentage. Okay, so question number 3, the population of a city decreased from 25,000 to 24,500. Find the percentage decrease, means decrease percent we have to find it. See, population of city decreased from 25,000 to 24,500. So how much amount change that we have to find first? So amount change right here, amount change. How much amount change? See, decrease from 25,000. From How much decreased from? Means it was 25,000, but it is decreased from 25,000 to 24,500. So how much it changed? That we have to find first. So amount change is equal to now 25,000 minus 24,500. How much will get? 500. Okay. So 500. Okay. See, you can do your calculation. 25,000. Actually, it is easy. So no need to show 24,500. Okay. So 0 minus 0, 0. 0 minus 0, 0. 0 minus 5 is not possible. So take borrow. 10 minus 5, 5. Here remain 4. 4 minus 4, 0. 2 minus 2, 0. So what we got? 500. Okay. So what we got here? 500. So what's amount change? Amount change is 500. So what it is asked? Find the percentage decrease. Percentage decrease. Decrease percentage we have to find here now. So write here percentage decrease. Okay. Decrease percentage or percentage decrease. Decrease percentage. So for decrease percentage, what is the formula for that? Amount of change. Means what it will come? What it is change? Population it is change, na? It is change or not? So that is amount of change. Amount of change.
Decrease percentage is